time of the year for us as Catholics, the sacred triduum of our faith, of Holy Thursday, Good Friday, Holy Saturday, and climaxing on the great feast of Easter. Today, Holy Thursday, as we know, we commemorate the Lord's Supper, the Last Supper, the time where Jesus spent his final, most intimate, and most important moments of his public ministry with his apostles, the 12, in the upper room. And the three most important things the church has reflected on from the Lord's Supper are that Christ instituted on this moment the Eucharist, the Blessed Sacrament, the priesthood, and charity, the gift of oneself to another. And sometimes it can be easy to look at these three things as somehow separate, somehow they're all good, holy, important parts of our faith, but maybe that they're not somehow all intimately connected. But today's feast reminds us in a very powerful way that the Eucharist, the priesthood, and fraternal charity, the gift again of oneself out of love for another, that they are fundamentally connected with one another. And the reason we know this is because all three of them have their source and power in Jesus Christ himself. When we look at the priesthood, for example, a priest is one who offers sacrifice. By our baptism, all of us have been commissioned by Christ to offer spiritual sacrifices to the Father, to pray for others on behalf of them, so that God will come to them, we can intercede for them. But as we also know, Christ picked his apostles, and from the apostles comes the priesthood, that within that group of disciples, that a certain group were picked in order to empower and to sanctify and to bring the whole to heaven, to lead the whole to heaven in acting the very person of Christ himself. Christ himself is the priest, every priest, myself, Father Jeff, Father Jordan, any priest or bishop you've ever known, fundamentally is rooted to the priesthood of Christ, because it is in his name that we act, it is by his power that we act in his name to lead, to sanctify, and to help teach and lead others to Christ himself. And it's this priesthood that Christ entrusted the very gift of himself, the most blessed sacrament, the Eucharist. As we know, Christ told his apostles at the Last Supper that he would soon be leaving. We just heard that the hour had finally come when Christ would be leaving this world, when the reason he came to the world was finally upon them, that he was about to suffer and to die so as to save us from our sins. But Christ in his love, Christ in his wisdom, Christ in his concern for his church, from that moment until this present moment, ensures us that his presence is with us. First off, he said that I will send to you the Advocate, the Holy Spirit, who will guide you and protect you throughout the all ages. But Christ has also left of himself to us in the most blessed sacrament, the Eucharist. Among the gifts that God has given us, it's hard to compare the gift of his body and blood, which he so lovingly, so generously pours himself out for us 2,000 years ago, as well as he does today, that whenever we celebrate the Mass, that same gift of Christ out of love, that same sacrifice of Christ is made present on the altar so that each of us at Mass can encounter that same saving moment that defined human history and changed our lives forever. And finally, charity. Charity being love that is given of oneself for another. And charity, as we know, is the bedrock of all virtues, faith, hope, and charity, but above them all is love, charity. And because of that, we know that Christ is with us. Because when we look at what we are celebrating now, the Paschal mystery of Christ, we know what Christ did, but when we look at the details, when we look at Jesus himself, we know why he did it. He didn't do it because he had to do it. Christ Christ did not suffer and die because he had to. He did out of love for us. And it was a love that sent itself to the point of suffering and death, so that we can have the chance of knowing God and forever turning away from sin and from evil. That the power of sin and evil, which had dominated humanity from the beginning of time since the fall, would finally be destroyed once and for all in the power of the cross. And for each of us now to be able to encounter that saving act that happened 2,000 years ago, but that has effects and fruit that last to this moment. And that is why we are here. We are not here just to remember what Christ did in the Last Supper as if it were some kind of historical footnote. We are here to encounter the living God in his word. We are here to encounter the living God in his body and in his blood, which he gives to us day in and day out, so that we can be strengthened and transformed by that same God who gave himself out of love for us. And we are also reminded at this Mass of, again, why Christ did it, out of love for us. He gave us so many examples in his public ministry of his love and of his concern for us. And at the Last Supper, he totally humbled himself by the act of washing his apostles' feet, this act of humility, this act of love, which he commanded them, therefore, to continue on through the ages. And at this Mass, we begin in a very powerful way now to enter into the saving mysteries of our faith, the most important moments of human history. Let us bring hearts full of gratitude to God. Let us bring hearts that acknowledge that, yes, we are all sinners, but that we have a God who gave himself to the point of death, so that sin and death would not have the last word in human history, but that God himself would have the last word. God is never outdone in his charity. And as we open ourselves to Christ, and we are nourished and strengthened by his presence in our lives, especially through the Eucharist, we are therefore made more and more, day by day, his image and his presence in this world. And it's that image and that presence which this world so yearns for, which this world so needs from us. We have this great commission from Christ to be his presence in the world. And tonight, at this Mass, we remember why we have that commission: to be the presence of Christ to others, to bring that love of Christ, which has first come into our lives and has affected our lives profoundly, and then to bring that to others, so that others may know why we have hope, so that others may know the source of our joy, and so that the world can see that there is a way to love. And that is not a thing, that is not a philosophy, that is not a government system, but that is a person, Jesus Christ, who is here with us in this moment and calls each of us by name out of love.